Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome back to another edition of Watch Me Work on Kiliox. Today we are going the full distance, absolutely non-stop, until we finish at least most of the face. What I'd really like to do is get all the fur stuff done, get the eyes done, get the nose done, possibly get the teeth done. Not really sure about that one because I've got to do the jowl work first. In fact, I might do the jowl stuff prior to doing the teeth on the miniature. But let's jump in, shall we? Already got my highlight color mixed up and we are ready to roll. So, got some on my brush. Let's do it. Alright, so we're just going to take this and kind of touch until I feel like we have accomplished what we need to accomplish. Alright. Hope that you're enjoying these Watch Me Works, especially this one on Kiliox. This is probably one of the most fun miniatures that we've worked on. I am really enjoying it myself. So hopefully you are as well. These highlights get real quick after you pass a certain point, so I'm hoping that with the speed at which we'll be able to apply these things, it shouldn't take too long at all. You're wondering if I'm still alive. Yes, I am. I'm just not talking. I apologize for that. Sometimes just feel like painting. Alright. If you're looking for an actual like tutorial, we got plenty of those. But this is a series that we call Watch Me Work. It's basically just where you can kind of watch a piece of art get created. A lot of people enjoy them. I enjoy doing them, so just kind of sit back, relax, grab some popcorn, grab your favorite non-alcoholic drink, and just enjoy yourself. Or you can do like a lot of people I've heard do, put this on the background, or in the background while you're painting your own miniatures, and just let it run and let it kind of be a relaxing background noise for you. Hopefully you'll enjoy that as well. Oops, a little bit too much paint right there. That's okay. Remember, as Bob Ross used to say, we don't make mistakes, we just have happy accidents. And boy, I can tell you, I have had a heap of happy accidents. A little bit of alliteration there. Well, I think we can all admit to having some happy accidents along the way. I know my first miniature felt like an entire miniature of happy accidents. Boy, it was basically a disaster, you know, if I wanted to be perfectly honest with myself. Don't remember if I got this. Yes, I did get this here. I couldn't remember if I gotten it or not. Ugh. All right. So that's that highlight. I told you these things get quick. They get real quick. So let's add some more color to this thing here. I guess technically we're taking color away. Because we're getting lighter in color. So let's see here. A little bit more color. We're just about, or as I can tell at least, just about at our next solid color, our next straight out of the bottle color, which is odd because I don't feel like we're quite where I want to be as far as the highlight goes, which means I'm going to have to figure out another highlight color, which I had not intended to do, because I was unprepared. I know it's shocking, right? All the times I've gotten on camera and hadn't had a brush or a knife or something to work with, it's hard to believe I'd be unprepared for something. Shame on me. Alright, a little more paint into the brush. This is my singing song, my painting song, my happy song. Alright. Okay. I'll tell you what, while you're sitting there not doing nothing, just taking a gander at this here video, why don't you hit that thumbs up button for posterity purposes? Alright. And then, if you feel so inclined, take this video and send it over to whatever kind of Facebook or social media page you got. And let your friends know you're watching it. Tell them how awesome it is. And say, you gotta check this feller out. He talks to himself. Sometimes in strange accents. Because that's what we do here. We have fun. And we paint. And we mumble to ourselves from time to time. Alrighty. There we go. I think that'll work. I'm starting to see some brightness in my highlights, which is great. Because I wasn't seeing it previously. So unfortunate it took me all the way until right before I get a straight color to see it. But alas, that is what has happened. That means to me we got at least two more colors to go before I feel as though this model is ready to be called done. Little bit of color here at the front, across the front up there too. Why not? Why not indeed? That's what I say. Alright, there we go. Boy howdy, that is a very expressive face. Let me kind of cover it up so that you can get the full effect of the highlights and the light doesn't kind of wash it out. Ooh boy, look at that. Man, that's sexy. How cool is that? Now again, I gotta take a good long hard look at this thing once we get it to where I want it to be and figure out, do I want to keep some of these dark areas as dark as they are? And there's a couple of spots that I'm really looking heavily at. See, right here down the center of the ears, I'm not real concerned about that. I think that works really well to kind of separate the ears out. What I'm concerned about, though, is this area right here on the cheek, which you guys can't see until I move the model into frame, and you definitely can't see if he's out of focus. There we go. Okay. Let's stay at eight times. Seven times. Eight times. There we go. All right. So, right there, that's a little dark for me. And then right here, inside the ears, I think that might be a little bit dark, too. But I don't know yet. I fixed the nose issue. I thought the bridge of the nose was a little bit too dark previously, but I think I fixed that to where I'm comfortable with it now. But these two areas, that ear and then that little piece right there, right in the center of that cheek area, are kind of bugging me. Now see, this ear over here, I think it's got enough color in it to where I'm not all that concerned with it. But this one, it's just so bare and so bright or so dark looking. I think I might take one of my mid-tone colors and kind of come in here and thin that dark stuff out. But I'm not sure yet. As I said, I got to get the whole thing painted up to kind of get the overall feel before I do any kind of modification to what I've done. So let's hit this next color, which is another straight out of the bottle color, finally. And we'll go from there. All right, so I'm just going to take some of this and gently, and I do mean gently, apply it to the model. Alright. I'll do something I hadn't done in a while. I'm going to do both ears right after each other. Wow! Amazing. Alright, there we go. That's fun. Now a little bit more color back here. Let me kind of rotate the model because I don't think you guys can actually even see what I'm doing when I do this. Let's see here if I can do this. Hold the model like this. Let me kind of reposition my body too. There we go. Okay. Ta-da! Little color in there. And a little bit more color in my brush. And then I think I'm going to come back to this side because I'm more comfortable painting this side first. A little color on the back there. A little color on the back there. Big chunk of paint that wasn't mixed together right there. Good job, Vallejo. Some of the colors in Vallejo will do that. I don't know why. It's very rare, but it does happen. Okay, got that taken care of. A little bit above the eye, a little bit right there on that thing, a little bit there. A little bit here on the cheekbone kind of area there. A little bit here on this jowl area there. Sort of like so. A little bit more water in my brush. And a little bit more paint on my brush. There we go. Yeah, this particular color that I'm working with, I think it's called golden yellow. Yeah, it is called golden yellow. Good job, Christopher, for remembering stuff. I don't know what it is. I think part of it's the fact that I've had it for years and I've maybe used it twice. It's almost the texture of it coming out of the thing, I think because it hadn't been used, hadn't really been shaken up that much. It's almost like it feels like it's got sand in it or something. It's chunky, it's clunky, and it's not very well mixed together, and it's not dissolving very well in the medium either. But that's okay. We will prevail. We'll use what we've got, and we'll make it work. By gum, if I got apple barrel paints, I'll make them work somehow. I don't know how, but I'll make them work. Alright. For those of you that don't know what apple barrel is, maybe you hadn't been in the painting game too long, or maybe you don't live in the U.S. I don't know if it's something available outside the U.S. or not, but there's a company that makes some paints called Apple Barrel and Apple Plaid. It's just real, real junky paints. You can find them at Walmart. They're craft paints, and they work in a pinch, and they work okay for painting terrain, but man, you try and use them on miniatures, and I tell you, you are in for a heck of a treat, because they will test your painting skills. Alright, so I think that highlight's basically done. Got some real good expressiveness going on here. Look at that now. Let me kind of cover out that light just a little bit there. Oh boy, look at that. So cool. Let's find another color that might actually work as a highlight. Was not planning on this one. Golly jeepers. Will beige work? Let's see here. How close is that? Yeah, let's go for beige. Why not? This may not work, but by gum, we gonna try. Alright, there we go. Now, I'm gonna need some more of that golden yellow on the plate. Otherwise, this is going to get real nasty real quick. Let's add some beige. And pray that this works well. Oh, gosh, that was a lot more beige than I had intended to put down. Let's see what she looks like. I'm not too hopeful about this, to be honest with you. I don't like that at all, to be honest. Yeah, that's crap. We don't want to do that. Okay, this is called trial and error at this point. Now we're going to go to white flesh. And this one's going to have to be shaken up massively because I don't think I've ever actually opened this bottle. Alright, actually that beige, once it's kind of mixed together a little bit better, doesn't look too bad. Huh. You know what? Let's do it. Hey, you know what? I was wrong. Note the date and the time. Christopher was incorrect about something. Alright. Not exactly what I would call ideal, but I look at it now. It's not too bad. I say that, but let's get some on the model and see how she looks. Alright. Just a little bit there. A little bit up top here as well. Okay. We're going to stick with this thing. However long it takes to get the face done. We're not cutting. This shot will not cut away. It's like a magic show. Only there's no elephant. He's already disappeared. Yay! I'm so good at magician stuff. Alright, let's see here. You guys ever watch that Magic Secrets Finally Revealed garbage? Man, I remember watching that when I was younger. And it was like, okay, let's show a video of the guy, you know, doing this trick. And it's like, I've never even heard of that trick. Is that something real, or did they just make that up for this special? It's kind of sad, to be honest with you. All right. Little bit more. Right here. Still trying to decide if that piece I just painted is actually a piece of the jaw or not. Not sure. Who knows? We'll figure it out at some point, I guess.
Or not. We might just leave it.
Alright, I think that's reasonable. Let's add another little bit of beige to that. Just see what happens. Actually, I think we'll have to go with straight beige at this point. So this is probably going to be it. Because I honestly just... I don't see going up too much further at all in a highlight color. I can't see it happening. So let's just see how this ends up looking. It may look like crap, I don't know. Okay. Get a little more water in my brush. The paint's not flowing off of it very nicely. So that's okay. Easy fix. Just about everything in the painting world is a pretty easy fix if you know what you're doing. Or if you have some relative idea of what you're doing. And a lot of that comes from making mistakes, children. The more mistakes you make when you're painting, the more knowledge you'll have for the next time. Okay, I'm going to leave a gap between these two this time. Do this right here at the front. I'll do this one here at the front. I think that's pretty good. I can deal with that. I'm liking it. Up there. Maybe a little above the eyes there, kind of like that. A little bit there. Touch there on the cheekbone. And then this other ear here. Do a little bit on that. Back of the ear, or the side of the ear. There we go. Alright. I think we're going to call that good. I kind of like it. I really do. So, let's do a little bit of extra work here. Let's do the eyes. Eyes are simple. That's just black. Where's my black? There we are. Get a little bit of expression into this thing. Ooh, that was a lot of black. Okay. Little paint into my brush. Wipe most of it off. And let's paint the eyes. Now I touched a little bit of that highlight color with the black, so let's come back and clean that up while I've still got some of that highlight mixed up on the palette. There we go. Okay. same thing on the other side. Okay. If I can reach the eyeball on this side, let's hope I can. That eyeball's much bigger. Much, much bigger. Alright, don't know if you can actually see that or not. Probably see it better on the other side. Not sure, I may end up adding a little bit to those eyes. I like the black look because it's more natural, but at the same time, you almost feel like it should have some kind of a color to it. I don't know, we'll see though. Let's deal with the nose now real quickly. This is going to be real simple. I hope. Okay. I'm going to screw the cap of my brown here. There we go. There's that. Okay. And let's deal with the nose. Be sure to get into the nostril. Just kind of blocking it out here. I'm not really doing any kind of detail work yet. I just want to get the shape of the nose before I do anything. And I like to do all this while I've still got some of my highlight colors mixed up, just in case I screw something up. I know it would be shocking if I mess something up. But on the odd chance that does happen, I would like to have the ability to fix it without having to remix a bunch of colors. Okay. Alright, that's not bad. A little cleanup work to be done there, but I think we can handle that. Alright, so let's see here. Let's put a little of this color here. Only a lot, just a bit. Okay. Don't think I really need too much on the other side there. Maybe a touch. Just a tiny, tiny touch. Alright. And I'll go ahead and clean up this top area too. I was going to kind of feather that out, but I don't think it looks real good. So I'll just make it a nice clean cut right across the top there. Okay. Alright. And then let's do the nose or the muzzle portion up here. Sort of gently dabbing over these areas with some paint, trying to get them mostly back to normal. And a little bit of that highlight color, that final highlight color, to bring it back up to where it should be. Do that on each side there. Alright, I think that's looking good. And then let's take a little bit more of that brown color and apply it right over here on the side, because I think this side needs just a little bit more. Here we go. And let's pull that color in a little bit there. Yeah, I think that'll be fine. That works good. Alright, now we just need to highlight that just a tiny bit. I'm going to add a little gray into that. Now let's use kind of gray do we want to use? Let's use dark gray. That's a nice, easy gray. There we go. And I'm not going to add much of a highlight to this. We need to add some more brown to it, though. There we are. Oh, yeah, much better. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here, I'm not going to apply this like I normally would. I'm going to wipe most of the paint off. And just kind of gently, sort of pseudo stipple slash dry brush across the top. If you ever look at a dog's nose, it's kind of textured, sort of like the paws of a dog. And so I want to kind of give that same effect right here. What I'll do is I'll add in a little bit more gray. And do one final highlight, and I think we'll call that done. Okay, that's a lot of gray, but I won't be touching the miniature too much with my brush, so I think we'll be okay with that. Wipe most of that off. Alright, and then just a little tiny hint of stippling slash dry brushing. There we go. Just to give it a little bit of color. Not much. A little bit of a highlight. And we'll call it done. Alright, let's take a look at that now. Let's see here. Make sure I don't have any weird looking areas. Alright, I think we're good. So we'll go ahead and stop for right now, and next time we come in, what I'd like to do is I'd like to work in the jaw area, so we'll probably come in and do the jowl stuff. In fact, you know what? I tell you what, let's do that right now. Why not? Why not indeed? Because if we wait, I tell you what, no, let's wait. I can cut the video. I was going to say if we wait, we're going to have a period of time, we're going to have to wait for the wash to dry, and I think... You know, I'll just cut the video after I do the wash, and we'll edit it back together, so that's fine. Right now, we'll call this good. Let's take a look at it. Let me get rid of some of the light here so you guys can see it a little bit more clearly. All right. Not too bad looking. I'm thoroughly pleased with the way it's turning out. Hope you guys are enjoying it as well. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to drop them in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't already done so. You don't want to miss any of these videos, do you? Of course not. So hit that subscribe button. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys today. Thank you very, very much for watching. God bless you all. Have an outstanding day, and I will see you all in the next video.